are till to you got your wives, however, whenever you want. Surah 4, Surah 4, 34.
Surah 2, 2, 2, you want 2, 2, 3, yeah? Okay.
That's a joke.
Sir, why didn't you listen?
No, no, sorry, I'm listening.
I read it to you. Do you want me to read it third time?
I want to read it. It's okay. Read it.
Okay, now you want to. Before you didn't want to read it. No, it seems I need to give you time to read it.
May I read it?
Please read it. You were afraid to read it before.
All right, listen. Listen, everybody that's listening on the camera. Your wives are a place of sowing of seed of you for you. So come to your place of cultivation, however you wish.
However you wish.
And put forth, and it says righteousness for yourselves. Put forth righteousness for yourself. And fear Allah. And know that you will meet Him. Okay? And give good tidings to the believers. May I explain?
What is that? Please explain.
I'm going to explain to you guys. This ayah.
What is your name, sir?
My name's Ali. This ayah can be looked at negatively by somebody. Okay?
You can. Why did you think that? You can't. I thought it's supposed to give lots of respect to the woman.
I'm going
to
explain to you the respect.
Please explain.
Let me explain to you.
Let her explain what she thinks.
I'm going to explain to you. So,
let her see what she thinks.
Allah Azza wa Jal has referred to the ladies or the wives as a farm, like a farm.
Field.
A field. Field. A farm.
That's already very disturbing.
Somewhere, let me continue. Somewhere that you plant your seed, okay? Yes. What is your seed? Your seed is your wife, okay?
The seed is the semen, okay?
All right. The seed is the semen. Is the wife here in
the
this context?
The wife is the field.
In this context.
Your,
understand it.
Field.
Understand it. Yeah. Our perspective. You've got your perspective. That means you can sleep with your wife whenever you want. Okay, our perspective, a farm for us is something that you can bear fruit from, yeah? But how can you bear fruit? How is this possible? You plant your seed, you have to give it water. You have to care about it. If it's too cold, you have to put something around the plant so it can survive, yeah? And the warning that comes after that, is be careful. One day you're going to meet Allah. What does that mean? Why did they bring it in this surah? It means if you're not righteous to your wife, if you don't look after her, if you don't treat her well, be careful, you're going to meet your creator one day. He's going to punish you for what you've done, if you are bad to the woman. If you want to take it out of context, you can. That's the meaning we've got. That's our perception.
Let me first of all respond. While you are apostate, Ali, according to your Muslim scholars,
apostate, not me.
Stay on, let us stay on topic. She's trying.
I denied Islam, but you denied Islam too.
I'm explaining to you, you're calling me apostate.
Yes, you are apostate because you simply said Allah is rubbish with his communication skills. So, your wives are killed to you.
The truth. You want to insult? Listen.
Sir, you insulted. Why are you told me? You told me that you respect woman. You are not even allowing me to speak. What kind of respect does Islam teach?
Let me say one thing and I'll let you speak.
No, sir. I already gave you time. You lied about your faith. You lied about your faith.
Me as a Muslim,
you are worshipping the black stone.
I cannot speak about them. I cannot speak about them because I'll tell you why. Millions of people, they follow these monkeys and the goat. I can't insult them. Nor does Jesus teach that.
Your prophet insulted.
Why are you insulting our prophet?
Insulted. Are you much better than your prophet?
People, you insult them.
Are you much better than your prophet?
Is that what Jesus taught?
Are you much better than your prophet?
Is this what Jesus taught?
Are you much better than your prophet? Because your prophet was quite okay to insult the other people's God and insult the other individuals. But that's not my topic.
Your leaders are my friends.
Now, you told me Islam teaches to respect the woman.
To speak with respect,
I am woman here. Last time when I checked, I was woman. And I am not getting any respect. I am not getting any respect. Of course, I am not getting any response because the ideology. Because the ideology simply tells and you can rape your wife, therefore they will never give respect to the people of other faith. Surah 223.
However,
whenever you want, that's the way you go to your wife. That is not respect at all. That is not respect at all. That was the first point, which you denied, yet Allah simply says, it is all right to rape your wife. Even the wife says, I don't want to have sex with you. You've got to go and have sex with her. The second point was, under the respect, I ask you, beating the wife, and then you say, no, we don't do that. So Muhammad did it. Muhammad did it. And Allah tells you, you can do so as well. Men are in charge of women. By what Allah has given, one over the other, and what they spend from their wealth. So righteous women are devotedly obedient, guarded in the absence of the husband, what Allah would have them guard. But those wives whom you fear, arrogance, advise them, forsake them in bed, and strike them. But if they obey you, seek no means against them. Indeed, Allah is ever exalted and grand. So you told me, get on the line, you told me you wouldn't beat your wife. Allah tells you, you can do so. Your prophet did as well to Aisha. Are you much better than your prophet, or you are apostate Ali?
I know. Shall I speak?
Answer the question. Are you much better than your prophet?
My prophet, this is what he said. They asked him, O Prophet Muhammad, who do you love more of your parents? He said, my mom. There's a reason he said my mom. First of all, it's for
Sir, what is the question? What did they ask him?
Who do you love more from your parents? Your mom or your father? Your mom or your dad? He said my mom. They asked him the same question again. He said my mom. They asked him the question again. He said my mom. Three times. My mom, my mom, my mom. And then he asked the question again. He said my father. Fourth. Okay? Why did he say that?
Because his father was dead before he was born.
It's respect.
His father was dead before he was even born.
Is the justice for women in Islam. Yeah? We have many justices. In our scriptures, in our Quran, in our ahadith, it shows we have to respect the ladies. We have to treat them right. All of these things, that's what they point for us.
So the way you respect the lady, you rape your wife. The way you respect the lady, you beat your wife. I am very much curious why Muhammad is saying that he loves more his mother. His mother was pagan. His mother is not even going to make the paradise like Muhammad is not going to make the paradise. According to you, I love to see that hadith first of all. That was just a coronation street hadith. Now, let's get on with Allah and get on with Muhammad. Allah, who is ordering beating your wife, and Muhammad, in his 50s, okay, he beat a child wife.
How?
Did Muhammad not beat Aisha?
She's not a child. She's not a child.
Aisha is not a child.
He didn't beat her.
He didn't beat her. He didn't do that. Sahih Muslim 2127. Muhammad struck Aisha on her chest, which caused her pain. I gave you the reference. Where is your ear? Take your that blanket. Take the blanket. You're able to hear it. Sahih Muslim 2127. That is the reference for that. So, now apostate Ali, since you know much better than Allah and Muhammad, let me come to the third point. On the prostitution.
What is your opinion?
Apostate Ali. Apostate Ali. If Muhammad turns up to your house today and then tells you he wants to have sex with your mom, would you allow that?
First of all, when you ask these questions directly, it comes across as disrespect.
What kind of disrespect? I am simply asking the question. If Muhammad turns up to your house today and asks to have sex with your wife, would she be okay with that?
First of all, if you give me time to answer, I would respect that. Okay? First of all, you said, when you refer directly to somebody, yeah, it comes across as rude. I'm not going to say about you,
I'm not going to say it, but as an example, I'm not going to say, if you're a prostitute, would you go to do something? I'm not going to say that, because we don't teach these things in Islam. We don't have that, number one. Neither does Jesus teach it, okay? Second thing, you refer to Aisha as a child. Yes? Your opinion.
No one cares about your opinion.
Your opinion that Aisha was young just shows your perception. Okay? Anyone can look at something, yeah, in a negative way. If they want. Even in Christianity, if I have so much hate in my heart against Christianity, I can go and find my research and I'll come to do something bad about Christianity and say stuff that are bad about Christianity, etc. In relation to Aisha, the Prophet's wife, okay, there's a hadith that states she was 19, 15, 16, and all of these ages, yeah, but you, because you have that perception, you're trying to find something bad, you go to the hadith that says she was 9. You don't mention the hadith that she was 15, 19, all of these. Let's just remember, these things happened thousands of years ago. Nobody knows exactly the truth back then, yeah? But there's a hadith that state different things. So my advice to you is, firstly, don't insult people, because it's not good. It's not good on your faith that you're trying to promote. Secondly, don't look at stuff with a negative concept. Even in life, if you look at it negatively, I can say my life is bad. I've got problems, I've got stress, I've got this, I've got that. But if you look into life in a positive way, you're going to see positivity. So just look into Islam with positivity and you're going to be positive.
Let me respond what you said.
Yes.
So you played around the bushes and you did not respond anything I simply said it to you. Point one. Can you please give me the references from the hadith where Aisha expressed she was 15, 16 or 19? Give me the reference. So I will give you time for you to figure out that reference. Second thing
is
was, listen,
something?
Listen.
Is it going to change something?
It will point
something.
Out that you did not lie.
I'm not lying.
Because so far you are lying.
All right,
so until
that.
You bring your reference. Second point is, why is it so difficult for Muslims to simply not answer the basic question? My question was about Allah is ordering husband to beat their wife. That was my question. You deny that Allah, you become an apostate,
minute.
Ali.
Can they see this? Just a quick search.
Sir, come to me. Brother, that's okay. Brother, that's okay. Sir,
all right.
Sir, make your case. What is the reference?
From the sun, they can't see it. Maybe this guy can see it.
Sir, right. tell me. You are, right. Remember, you all said right. you have a lot of respect to the woman, but you are not all even right. giving me the reference.
All right, I'm give
I don't
you.
Have to earn the respect,
give you a
because Quran already identifies me as the worst of creatures. Allah and Muhammad is quite okay to insult my God. So therefore, it should be very simple for you to justify for me. While your Allah is telling you can beat your wife,
you ask for the
why you disagree with that?
You show her the reference. Can I have a mic? In 1 second, quick search, all biographers of the Prophet agree that he consummated...
Which biographies?
That he
give me the names.
That he consummated his marriage with Hazrat Aisha in 2 years hijrah. It can be said conclusively that she was 19 at the time.
Watch the
of
face
marriage,
of lying.
And not
this is
lying
the face
as
of
alleged,
lying.
As alleged by
Aisha.
You.
Aisha.
Don't skip the story.
Aisha.
Don't skip.
Aisha.
You're skipping. You're
Sahih skipping Bukhari. Sahih Muslim. TBD.
Go to Google.
You don't need to go to Google. Go to the most reliable Islamic sources. Six hadith. Aisha herself says she was 6 years old and Muhammad thought it was alright to have sex with her when she was 9 years old.
How old was your mom?
And what you noticed that Muslim lied and ran away. Wonderful Islam. While according to Muslims, Islam teaches respect to the woman. What kind of respect is that?
You
Look, you hear that? You hear that? Respect, change.
This woman.
Respect, change from one line to other line. Here's the bottom line.
This woman deserves respect.
Sir, just a moment,
and
sir.
And she deserves for men not to crowd round her. She's debating one man, yet you are in her ear.
It's okay, sir. That's fine. That's fine. So here's the bottom line. Of course, it is free speech. So it is free speech when they abuse me, but it is not free speech when I talk about Allah who orders beating of the wife. When I talk about Allah who orders the rape of the wife, that is not free speech.
Who's Allah?
That Allah also calls me the worst of creatures. That is not free speech.
Why are you not answering?
But the moment I say it back, that becomes hate speech. If you are not interested, walk away, sir. Walk away, sir. Allah is the one. Allah is the one who thought it was all right to call me as the worst of creatures. Allah is the one. Listen, I am answering your question. Allah is the one. Allah is the one who taught you actually it's all right to have French kiss with the Blackstone. Allah is the one who ordered you to rape your wives. Allah is the one who tells you. Allah is the one. Allah is rubbish. Allah is just rubbish. So now, sir, can you tell me?
Okay.
Would you rape your wife?
She said Allah is rubbish.
Would you rape your wife?
She said Allah is rubbish.
Would you rape your wife? I describe who Allah is. Would you rape your wife?
I don't need to go Allah is rubbish, she said, yeah?
I don't want to insult rubbish. I know some rubbish can be recycled, but Allah cannot.
Can you read Arabic?
Sir, just focus on.
Can you read Arabic?
Would you follow the teachings of Allah and rape your wife?
You don't agree that he's good?
Would you follow the teachings of Allah and rape your wife?
Can you read Arabic?
Would you follow the teachings of Allah and rape your wife?
Listen,
so you don't want to engage? Gentlemen doesn't want to engage.
Translation for you.
Sir, my question is very simple.
Ask your question.
Would you follow the teachings of your Allah and rape your wife and beat your wife?
No, I wouldn't.
You wouldn't.
Now listen to what I'm saying.
Another apostate from Speaker's Corner. His moral standards are much better than Allah. Allah is ordering to rape your wife, but Muslim doesn't want to do it. Well done to the Muslims. Allah is ordering to beat his wife, but Muslim doesn't want to do it. Another apostate at Speaker's Corner. Welcome to the apostate corner.
You're
now on.
The last time she debated
I'm done with you.
She lost.
Sir, watch out.
Yeah? Where are you going? Why are you running away from?
I'm done with you.
No, I wouldn't mean you're done with me.
I'm done with you. You can't even be recycled.
Where is the video that we did last a couple of weeks ago?
Who are you?
What do you mean, who am I?
Yeah, who are you?
You've been exposed as a liar.
Of course I'm
You've
exposed.
You've been exposed. I did a debate with her.
Of course I am exposed.
3 weeks ago I did a debate
of
with her.
Of course I'm exposed.
Her team recorded it. I could not find it on the YouTube channel.
I didn't make you famous. I didn't want to make the apostate famous.
No, sir,
I'm done with you.
You're running away.
I asked you a question three times.
You
didn't answer. I'm done with you. Are you Muslim? Are you sure?
Yes.
It didn't look like you were sure.
Don't go away. Once again, Hatuntash, where are you going? Allah in Arabic, yeah?
Sir, are you Muslim?
Anyone? Once again, I'm in the middle of talking.
Are you Muslim, sir?
This is how Allah is spelled in Arabic.
Sometimes there is a denial.